Hello, my loves. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Jess from Bahati Life. Thank you so much for tuning in. Let's talk about this week ahead, shall we? So on my left, I have the astrology chart pulled up for this week, starting February 3rd, 2020. There's a lot of changes going on with this week, and we'll talk about it in detail in just a moment. And then at my feet, I have some notes so that I don't miss a beat. And I say that because I want you guys to know what it is that I'm looking at and how I'm pulling the charts. Okay, so that you know what to expect. On that note, let's go ahead and dive in. So if you are new to my channel, welcome, number one, welcome. But there's one thing that I say a lot here, and that's pretty much that if you know how to work with the planets, you can make them work for you and not against you. And if you are part of the Bahati Vibe tribe, you have heard me say this so many times, and you've also heard me say that I'm really about to get it tattooed right across my chest because it is like a motto for me at this point. But the reason why I say this is because I feel as though no matter what your astrology chart looks like, no matter what is going on in your life, you're perfectly capable of making the circumstances benefit you in whatever way that you wish and that you choose. But you just have to understand the energy of what it is that you're working with. That's what you can expect in this video, and that's what we're gonna talk about now. So I do wanna say, before I dive in, before I even look into this week, I have to kind of take a few steps back. This is kind of to remind us of what it is that we've already been working with. So just because we're starting a new week doesn't mean the energy of the planets is totally brand new, although there are a lot of new changes that are happening specifically for us this week. A few things that stand out to me is the fact that the sun has been moving to the sign of Aquarius, Mercury was moving to the sign of Aquarius, and is now moving into the sign of Pisces. Basically what's happening, I don't know if you guys have noticed this yet or if you've been feeling this, but there's this really big call right now to kind of detach and separate yourself from certain specific security blankets, certain specific energies. And the crazy thing is that sometimes we don't realize how attached we are to certain things, even if that is a person, a place, a thing, an opportunity, a lifestyle, a mindset, it could be an outcome. And we see this a lot when it comes to law of attraction. At this point, a lot of people have heard about laws of attraction, and the main key point to help you to manifest certain things with the law of attraction and to master the law of attraction is to master detachment. And basically that is to disconnect yourself from the outcome so that you can allow it to kind of free form and free flow into all that it will be, so that you can see what it is that you're setting intention for manifest. Now, it's not just outcomes, it's not just ideas, it's not just relationships or things that it is that we're trying to hold on to or trying to build into our lives. It's the universe is showing you and has been showing you the last 3 weeks that there are certain things, certain people, certain situations that it is time for you to detach yourself from, to cut the umbilical cord, so to speak. And it will present itself in really specific but also sometimes subtle ways that shows you that, you know what, this is not what I want, this is not where I want to be, this is not how I want to live my life, this is not who I am, this is not what I wanted, this is not what I expect, and the list goes on and on. The thing that was coming to me the last 2 weeks, is this image of someone putting an electrical cord into the plug, and then those sparks, like a little spark coming off. And it's that subtle like, whoo, what was that? What was that? Or I don't know if you guys have ever done this, but I do this and it shocks me literally and figuratively every single time. But you know when you're walking on carpet and then you touch someone and then there's like a little shock there? That's kind of what the last few weeks have been like, especially the last week, but specifically the last 2.5 weeks. And pretty much what this is energetically is it's a spark that reminds you, oh, there's something here, there's something there. We want you to pay attention to it. Now, depending on your natal chart, depending on your astrology chart, whatever that thing is different per person because everyone's situation is unique. But it's all there to kind of show you that there's certain things that it's time for you to remove yourself away from, not because they're negative, not because they're bad, but because they are not there to serve you, or that your attention needs to be directed elsewhere, that your energy, your unique gifts need to be directed in a different direction in order to maximize whatever it is that you need to be doing, or whatever it is that the planets, the divine, wants you to do at this moment in time. Now, at the start of this week, February 3rd, which is a Monday, Mercury moves out of the sign of Aquarius and into the sign of Pisces. And basically what this is, Mercury is a planet of communication, thoughts, ideas, expression, messages, all of those things start to come to the forefront. And when Mercury moves into the sign of Pisces, our focus starts to shift. And when I say that, it's almost as if it becomes impossible for us to focus in the way that the majority of us know what focus looks like and, you know, what we expect focusing to be. So let me take a step back. So sometimes when we think about focusing and setting intention, or when we're working on something specific, or when we're communicating with someone, we use certain words in order to get our point across. But as Mercury is moving to the sign of Aquarius, it's almost like, wait a minute, you know, let me kind of reassess, let me kind of reevaluate, let me detach myself from the outcome in order to see things from a bigger perspective so that I can make changes and implement them in the way that best serves my goals. And the reason why is because Aquarius is co-ruled by Uranus and Saturn, right? So basically, Uranus creates this energy that says, think differently, do differently. Saturn will do the same thing, but in a different way, because it wants to create structure, stability that serves the greater, that serves, but, and then also you and your root, like your foundation, it wants you to have stability. Meanwhile, Uranus will kind of disrupt patterns that aren't serving you, like kind of pulling a grenade and throwing it in there and then running, because it says, listen, it may be serving you now, but when it comes to the long haul, it's not going to be good for you. And we can see that before you can even see it yourself. This is how the universe works in overdrive in order to protect you and ultimately, like, your plan, your gifts, your purpose, right? So there's been this energy lately of kind of detaching and pulling back so that you can make changes, or at least feel that spark, that shock, to help you to be aware that there are changes that need to be made. Now, as Mercury moves into the sign of Pisces, we really, really want to stay open and flexible with this. It is true that when Mercury is moving through Pisces, he, she, because it's a like genderless kind of planet, is in its fall, which means that it doesn't operate usually in the way that is its most comfortable and the way that people usually are most comfortable, but it varies again depending on what your natal chart looks like, what your astrology chart looks like. But pretty much what it is like Mercury loves to kind of shoot forward. But when Mercury moves into the sign of Pisces, it's really working with the realms of intuition, with the subconscious, with the unknown, with feelings and intuition. So that is not a bad thing. That's actually amazing. But you want to be able to be open and flexible to working with this, and don't expect for your mind to be sharp, for your thoughts and your words to be razor sharp. If anything, this is more about kind of falling back into, and I want to call it like a trust fall, kind of trust falling back into the universe and allowing yourself to kind of receive, you know, messages and inspiration and ideas, and don't box them in, but capture them. So journal them. This is when things, this week, dream work is so amazing. Like, if you work with dream work, and if you work with the subconscious, if you're trying to connect with your guides, if you're trying to get creative and pull in inspiration, this is the best week to connect with those realms. But it's not the best week when it comes to cementing those realms, because it's impossible. It's not possible. So do you see how if you know how to work with the energy of the planets, you can actually make it work for you versus against you? If you try to box this energy in, if you try to get your point across and for it to be understood and heard clearly by another person, it almost feels like the odds are stacked against you. However, if you work with this energy and you fall back and you allow yourself, you know, your mind to kind of drift, even as you're at your desk and you're in like la la land, and you're allowing your imagination to kind of like make whatever it is, capture those ideas, capture those thoughts, capture those images, maybe even work with your intuition or use your dreams, call out to your spirit guides in order to help you to use your dreams to inspire you or to deliver messages through you, to you through your dreams. That is how you can work with this energy to your benefit. What I don't want you guys to do is to box yourselves in, because for the entire month of February, you guys, Mercury is going to be making a lot of waves in this big ocean abyss that it's going to be swimming through, specifically on the 17th, because that's when Mercury is going to go retrograde. Now, before you start groaning and complaining about the annoyances that Mercury retrograde can bring, realize that this is a chance, and what I want you to do is to take these ideas, these re-emerging thoughts and ideas from past lives or past, you know, ideas that have surfaced like months ago or years ago even, or lives ago. Allow yourself to open up to receive those messages, and don't think, you know, into the future. We already did that. We exited out of thinking about future planning when Mercury was moving to the sign of Aquarius. Now we're working with the realms of the subconscious, with healing, with our intuition. And when Mercury goes retrograde, those past lives, those past messages, those past divine guidance that you may have missed in the months, years ago, or weeks ago, will come resurfacing now. So work with that. If you know how to work with the energy of the planets, you can make this work for you, not against you, but you have to know what energy it is that you're working with. So this is going to start on the 3rd. On the 5th, Mercury is going to sextile Uranus, right? And basically what happens starting on the 5th and around the energy of the 5th, so the beginning of this week, is that you want to be so open to divine intervention. You want to be so open to new ideas, new concepts. You want to be so open to new areas of healing, new platforms. I don't know why that just came through, but new platforms for healing and different modalities, different belief systems, different theories, working with different guides. I mean, the list goes on and on. You want to be very open to it, because how like your best healing, your best concepts, your best ideas can really come through and wash up on your shores, so to speak, through the unknown, through unexpected, especially when it comes to the subconscious. Things that were hidden from you, now they kind of come up. And that's not a bad thing. That's an amazing thing. Now it's like a gift, a piece of treasure. If you think about mermaids, I moved to Florida, so the energy of mermaids is something that I've been really interested in lately. But if you think about mermaids, it's like they're like the guardians of this ocean, like the realms of the ocean that are off limits to walking mankind. And these mermaids, they kind of protect these treasure, but every once in a while, if you know how to work with them, if you know how to listen to their siren song, if you know how to communicate with mermaids, not to say that they're real or they're not, that's a topic for another discussion, but they can bring you the treasures of the ocean that are hidden from you. They can bring it to your shore, knowing that, okay, at this point, the waves are gonna bring this in, the tide is gonna carry this in. So use that metaphor to help you to work with what is going on with these realms right now, is that there are hidden treasures that have been, you know, shipped from shipwrecks, from past destructions, from past moments in history, from your life, that if you know how to call in your guides, and if you know how to work with your guides, or to work with your dreams, or to allow your mind to drift, and to allow your pencil to just kind of go and capture those creative moments, you will be so surprised and so shocked and in awe of what the universe, what the subconscious will bring to you, at your shore effortlessly when the tide comes in, ultimately, right? So don't get annoyed by these energies, get inspired by them, work with them, and they will work with you tenfold. I promise you. The other thing that's standing out to me is the fact that Venus, now in Pisces, she's been spinning in Pisces for a minute now, just living her best life, is going to be moving into the sign of Aries on the 7th. This is really going to change what we are attracted to and how we're able to magnetize things towards us. So this is when it just feels like what it is that we want it in our faces, we want it here, now, present, we want it aggressive, we want red, we want fire, we want passion. So those are things that it is that you can experience now as Venus is moving into, and as she moves into the sign of Aries on the 7th. And then to tie it all up in one nice, really pretty bow is the full moon that's going to be happening in the sign of Leo. Now, if you want to hear about the details of this, then make sure you are subscribed to this YouTube channel and that you do have your notifications turned on, because I'm going to be diving into this in full detail in just a moment after this video is done uploaded. But pretty much what this is again, remember how I was talking before about what it is that, or how the planets and how the universe has been asking you to kind of detach and cut certain cords and, you know, switch the game up a little bit and help, and be more open to implementing changes. Well, when this full moon happens in the sign of Leo, this is going to kind of light that match and light the candle, and, or maybe like a domino effect almost, not necessarily a bad thing. Again, we want to know how to work with these energies and not work against them. But pretty much what this does is it kind of puts all of this energy in our forefront of our face. It says, look at me, observe. What is it that you want to create? What is it that you love? What is it that you value? What are you attracted to? What are you attracting? Now that you know that, what do you need to change in order to align with what it is that you ultimately see for yourself? If everything is going good and dandy and you love it and you like it, then keep it as is and keep your vibration strong and celebrate. But if there are certain things that you want to shift and that you want to change, go ahead and make those changes now. Why? And again, I'll go into the full detail of the full moon in my next video, so make sure you are subscribed and your notifications are turned on. But why is this? Because if I look at the full chart and I see all of what's going on in the planets at this time, we have Saturn, Pluto, Jupiter in the sign of Capricorn that's working on our security, our stability. Mercury is moving to the sign of Sagittarius, which says, listen, we're gonna go big or we're gonna go home, and we're not going home. So we wanna think big, we wanna think outside of the box, we wanna live large, we wanna live proud, we want to be assertive and you know, actively believe and work to achieve the things that it is that we ultimately see for ourselves in this bigger vision. Sun moving through the sign of Aquarius is like detach, detach, detach. Separate yourself from the things that are holding you back. Be unapologetic about it. It's not selfish, it's good, because when you are making these moves for your highest and greatest good, it serves all of us. That's a topic for another discussion. Mercury moving through the sign of Pisces says, listen, you may not know all of the pieces of the puzzle yet, but open up to receive it and you will be guided. You will be inspired. You will have ideas, things will flow. And then work with the hidden realms, especially as we're preparing for Mercury to go retrograde. But again, that's another topic for another video. And Neptune is connecting us to the collective consciousness. That was a mindful and a mouthful. So all of this energy is coming through, and Venus is moving through the sign of Aries. All these things are making themselves known and highlighted and pushing it in your face. And what are you going to do with it? What are you going to do with it? What are you going to create? So that's what it is that I'm seeing for you guys. I hope that this video made sense. I know that it's a lot of information. I do go live every Monday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on my YouTube channel, where we talk about these energies together as a group, as a collective. So make sure again that you are subscribed to the YouTube channel. Turn on your notifications and set your alarms, bring your notebooks, and we'll talk about it in detail. Until then, thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you to everyone who shares, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.